today I'm starting with 50 pounds. It says using a recipe dating from George II's 1736 Gin Act, distinctive piney juniper balanced by citrus and coriander. It's served with Frenchman and Sons Indian and a lime. So, who better than to serve me than my husband Eric? I see it coming, it looks nice.
This is 50 pounds. You're gonna like this. This happens to have a piney junipery flavoring with a citrus and coriander overtones. And there's some junipers, lime, and some rosemary sprigs in there. And served with a Franklin and Sons tonic water, natural Indian.
So I've decided what I'm going to do with all these. First, I have just a little sip just to see what the gin is like by itself. Thank you so much, Eric. Just keep on coming. It tastes like gin. You know, it could be that after I've done this for a while, I start getting a better palate. But right now, gin. Okay. So this is natural Indian tonic water. I have no idea what that means, but we have so many varieties of tonic water here. I found out I don't think about a little less than half the tonic. Splash more. I've never been a gin and tonic drinker. What I usually go for is gin and lemonade. Really good. Don't knock it when you try it. Also, there's a great summer drink called Peach Fuzz Fuzz, which is fresh peaches blended with ice or frozen peaches and gin. No anything on it, included. And I think it has a splash of some citrus. Maybe it's lemonade or maybe it's a sweet and sour mix. But it's delicious and refreshing. So back to our 50 pounds. I wish I could say I smell these things. I do smell a little bit of the rosemary and the lime. It has juniper and berries in there. Now I'm tasting the rosemary. It's very refreshing. I've tried off camera 3 gins so far, and four gins. And I thought that about all of them except for one. I wasn't crazy about it. So maybe that's just the thing with gin and tonic. Very refreshing. I don't know. I like to taste the alcohol in mine. So I'm not a big fan of tonic water. I don't like that bitter aftertaste. So I find that today I use almost half the bottle. But with the sweeter ones, I've been using less to do up here. It looks very nice. The presentation with the rosemary, juniper berries, and the lime is lovely. The glass is perfect. I wish I could take you out in the dining room, which is very charming. But since we have guests, I don't want to annoy them with my commentary, especially since I'm unlike Ruth and Richard, who know what they're talking about when it comes to gin. I may just confuse people. What is she talking about? It's just refreshing and tonic's bitter. That's the best I can come up with. Again, tonic is kind of new for me. I've had gin and tonic in my life and I didn't like it, probably because it was heavy on the tonic. So, I'm definitely no expert here, but this is very nice. I would definitely have it again. I think it would pair nicely with anything. I mean, it would go nice with salad. Today it's a bougie sunny day outside. It could be a nice thing to sit outside and just, you know, eat some munchies. Okay, I think I'm going to be eating to the blue of life with my gin. And, or, you know, a chicken dish, steak. Actually, I think Jim has this with anything. If you want to, drink this. If you don't want to, don't, you know, just have the gin. But it, I think it would go good. Eat fruit. If I have an apple, I would drink it. My gin master, we just want to make sure that the gin is good. It is good. He's done well so far at recommending. In fact, the first three I had, he recommended marvelous. He kind of understood exactly what I wanted, I think. And then I said, you know what, I think I want to write down the menu. And so the next one that I had was my least favorite, so maybe some of these I probably won't actually care too much for. It's only been one so far, but we'll see. The game is early, but see what it's like when one becomes a gin critic. The making of a gin critic. You see my first video right here. Okay. If you could call that one a wrap, I would recommend this.